Welcome to the Mother Church of Country Music. This is where Mom wanted her public celebration to take place. And thank you for being in community and in fellowship with us, because we can pretend to care, but we cannot pretend to show up. So thank you for showing up for our mom. And at this time, when I am so forlorn, I say to my Creator, I do not know who you are, and yet I do know who you are, because you are the one who saved me. And in the dark night of the soul, I say to myself, I do not know who I am, yet I do know who I am, because I am the one you saved. Our circumstances do not have the power to name our identity, because as my mother taught me, we are spiritual beings having a human experience. And God comes to us disguised as our life. Diana Ellen Judd was born on the 11th of January in Ashland, Kentucky, a small coal town in the foothills of Appalachia, later taking her identity into her own hands, as was her wont. She changed her name to Naomi. Her parents were young. Pauline Ruth was a teenager when Naomi was born, and her daddy Glenn had an Ashland oil filling station. She was the eldest of four children, and as she wrote in her own hand on the back of a picture, she was a happy child who was always smiling. Belonging and connection defined her, and even as a youngster, she was the one who remembered everyone's birthdays in her family, and she believed there was a crocodile named Gillette who lived in the basement. Pregnant at 17, when her family was falling apart in crisis as her brother Brian was dying of childhood cancer, Naomi married, and she gave birth again at 22. She was full of yearning, and she was restless. The emergence of her older daughter's unmistakable musical brilliance at about the age of 8 midwifed in her a dream, a spectacular Technicolor dream that broke with her family's humble heritage. And who knows from where her powerful imagination came? Maybe it was the books in the library on Central Avenue in Ashland, Kentucky. She cultivated those preternatural mother-daughter harmonies and eventual stardom. And the result is that we are here. Tonight, remembering an icon and a legend who left country music better than she found it. Since the 30th of April, we have been remembering the complex and dynamic life of our mother in story. She was every woman. Perhaps this is why everyone felt they knew her. She was a nurse. She was a single mom who sometimes relied on public assistance. She was traumatized by early childhood sexual abuse, intimate partner violence, and rape, and she was fired by a boss when she refused to go away with him for a weekend. She was mama to her grandchildren, Elijah and Grace, and to my chosen family, and she was totally extraordinary. The 5-time Grammy Award winner, the multi-platinum artist, the Hall of Famer, who was lauded by millions. And tonight, we remember her in song. And so for our first song, one she wrote about the tincture of time, is the one with whose voice I grew up, to me the goat, the greatest of all time. Please welcome my big sister, Wynonna.
Mother Church. those happy years, like all the good times that are no more. My mama is gone, gone, gone forevermore. In silence so deep, only my soul can hear. It says now the past is what I fear. And the future isn't what it used to be. And only today is all that's promised me. And I sing, words. Here we go. Flow on, river of time.